Meanwhile, a European delegation is set to travel to Iran next month in a groundbreaking effort to boost economic ties. Our correspondent Jack Parrock reports from Brussels.
Celebrations in Iran marked the lifting of sanctions. But now, after the jubilation, comes the hard work.
Its proper implementation will be a key contribution to improved regional and international peace, stability and security.
Less than a week after the lifting of sanctions, the European Union's announced it's sending a delegation to Iran to begin rebuilding trade ties. Oil's likely to be high on the agenda for both sides. The EU's looking to diversify its energy sources away from Russia following the Ukraine crisis, and it comes at an opportune time for Iran's oil industry, which has stagnated in recent years, producing only a third of the volume of competitor Saudi Arabia. Iran's president Hassan Rouhani says he expects international investment to reach $50 billion next year, and experts say that would bolster Iran's position as a major economic player in the Middle East.
What we're seeing as well is European and American companies trying to invest in Iran on strategic industries there, especially air and space, especially automobile.
Renault is expressing interest in setting up new manufacturing operations in Iran. The French carmaker is also thought to be considering taking a stake in the state-owned carmaker Pars Khodro, which assembles Renault vehicles in Iran.
The Iranian president Hassan Rouhani is visiting Europe this week for his first diplomatic offensive since the nuclear deal was signed, as the European Union is beginning to explore possible avenues for cooperation which may pave the way for more senior level visits to Iran in the coming months. Jack Parrock, CCTV, Brussels.